Hi everybody, it's Mel from Everything Marmy. So I had enough people want to know how I made this little trifold here. I did include the link from the original person who created this little book. And it's all caught up. It's a little book that has 6 pockets. 3 in the inside of it, and when you turn it around, it has 3 on the outside of it as well. 1 in the middle, 1 there at the front, and 1 at the back. I did that backwards, back in front. Okay, so how I made it was I first started off with just taking a piece of wallpaper that's the tall size. And I took the thinner wallpaper and I folded that in half to make the bottom, and I folded this and that in half to make the top, and I just inserted one in front of the other, inside of the other, like that. And now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to stitch here, and I'm going to stitch here, and that's going to make the trifold, and it's going to make the 6 pockets. And I'm not going to show you the sewing part because the sewing part's pretty elementary. It's just a zigzag stitch that I do on my printer, or on my printer. How can you tell I've been working on my sewing machine? And that'll make the basis and foundation for this book. And then once I'm done doing that, I'll come back and see you all and show you and tell you what I'm going to do next. Okay, I will see you soon. So I've decided to show you some of the sewing from a different angle. So I've sewn 1 bit of this to make the pocket here and the pocket in the back. And now I have just 1 more sewing area here. And I let the machine guide me. So wherever this space is here is basically how I measure, because I essentially measure nothing. And of course, that's how I did this one here, is I used the distance between the space and the needle's arm to measure it for me. And I've just used this one here as a guide to go against this time. So I'm gonna go ahead now and finish sewing this, and I'll speed this part up. In case you did wanna watch it, I'll hopefully reduce it to a minute, but I have to stop it and start it each and every time to do this. So it's gonna be a little choppy, and I hope you all don't mind. All right, I'll see you in a bit. Okay, so I'm trying not to shake the camera. So basically in this one, I didn't even fold it first. I just sewed here all the way down, sewed here all the way down, and I sewed the 2 ends. And if you watch my last clip, the reason I went is because right at the end I had to re-thread my bobbin and I didn't want to do it on camera, so, which was easy to do. But so now, as you can see, there are pockets here at the bottom. And there are pockets here at the front. And this is gonna be the front because of the dangly shoes are in the correct way, whereas they're upside down there. So now all I do is I fold it. And I think I'm gonna have to remove the sewing machine and change the angle. So hopefully I don't make you dizzy. All right, guys. So I really apologize for all these stops and starts, folks, because I don't have a cameraman that follows me around. But basically all I've done now is I've just folded her along those lines that I showed you last time. The wallpaper did catch here, so there's a little bit of a nick in her, but that's fine. And it was easy to fold along the sew lines because the natural fold came easily. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through this Beautiful Day paper pad, which has kind of a Paris-y kind of theme. It's got some die cuts and whatnot, kind of a Paris-y theme with the coffee and the scones and all of that. And I'm going to come up with, what did I do in mine? What did I do? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I did 10 total sheets, so 5. So I'll do another 10 total sheets on this one. And that'll, and fold it in half, so that'll give it 40 working sheets. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pull those papers now, and then I'm going to cut them on my little Fiskars cutting machine here to be about 4.75 by 4.5, and then I'm gonna fold, by the time they're folded in half, it'll be just like a traveler's notebook size. And then I'm gonna use the Crop-A-Dile, which I can probably do now, actually, and show you how I did that. So on this one here, what I did was I poked holes along the edge, but I had used, I just pinched it, you see, and used the Crop-A-Dile to poke holes in it for me. So I can show you that because that's pretty simple. And I don't measure anything. And I'm gonna use this, this one right here, the little thin guy over here. And all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go down. So there's where the closure will be. So I wanna go against where the book will be. So if that's the front of the book there, then I want to have that as the wrap around the button on this side. So therefore I'm gonna poke holes along here. So I'm just gonna use my little Crop-A-Dile here. And I always have to keep checking to make sure that I'm going down the right area. And I'm gonna go about the center and poke a hole. Once I make sure that it's down enough. I don't want it too far down, otherwise I will have signatures too far apart, and I don't want that. And a signature is just a grouping of papers. So that's about right. So I just wanna start somewhere around the middle, poke a hole, and there you can see right through it here. My finger is. Then I'm gonna move an inch over, do another one, and another inch over, and do another one. And I'm gonna go an inch over from this one, do another one, and an inch over, and do another one. And that may or may not be a perfect inch, but it doesn't matter because it's close enough, and I'm a close enough kind of gal. So as you can see, it's really kind of hard to see, but you do see the double holes because I'd fold it in half. And that's where I'm going to thread all the threads through. And when I fold the papers, I'm going to use the same Crop-A-Dile. I'm going to show you how I do that as well. So I'm going to go ahead and pick my papers. I'll come back after I've cut them and folded them, and I will show you how I cut them. And then I don't know how to let this continually run unless you guys Yeah, you know, if I had set this up, maybe it would have been okay, but I just find it's kind of boring just to watch me pull and cut papers. So I'm going to do that and then I'll come back. Okay. So this next part is simple, folks. So I've just lined up my papers with the holes here that I've already punched with the crop-a-dial. And I'm going to try to see if I can do this while I'm on camera here. Is I'm just going to mark these holes like that. Like I said, I don't measure really anything. I just kind of approximate everything. So that's all I do. And then I took the crop-a-dial, the little one that's right here on this side, and I've already gone ahead and poked half holes basically in these ones here because I just want a single hole for these individual signatures. And I wanted a double hole here so I could have one on both sides so I could sew one signature there and one signature there. So that's why I've done that. So very quick. Okay, I will see you soon. Hey everybody, so I ended up making two journals and I had planned on doing that all along, and that's why when you guys were watching, if you watched the whole thing, you would have seen me sewn in some different papers, because I ended up for one of them using the LOL package to get the amount of papers of the same thickness that I got in my particular journal here. The other one, I did use the, the Beautiful Day, this one here. I used just 8 total sheets, so a total of 32 pages, because they're much thicker in that book. And so, I'm going to extend this to be part of the draw on Sunday. So I've made 2. One's a pink one, and one is a yellow one. And we just have a button on along the side here. The yellow one, let me just unwrap it. There's no fancy name on it yet or anything. I haven't done that because I thought I would customize it if you wanted it customized. So this one has the LOL paper in it. And by all means, folks, these are not perfect, okay? These are not perfect. That's my disclaimer right off the bat. I am a shabby chic artist at best. And that means that I don't measure anything. I just kind of go with the flow. I use what materials I have, what resources and what patience I have at the moment, and how much time I have. So that one there, I just put together this tassel. I used the birdhouse that Trina gave me off of her beautiful charms today in friend mail, out of this beautiful pouch. She had gifted me some butterflies, and you can see I just tore them off because with these nails it's kind of difficult. You should have seen me threading them. So that was the other issue. Sewing and doing things with medium length nails is a little bit more difficult. So one of them had the birdhouse, which is the yellow one here, the birdhouse on it, and the LOL papers. And the other one has the butterfly on it, and it has the, just told you guys too what it was, and I forget already. The brutiful day, as in I'm brewing coffee. And this one looks like this on the inside. Like that. And these are thicker pages. But you get less pages out of them. So there's only 32 total pages in here. And there's 40 total pages in here. So I'm going to be including at least, I'm going to say at least one of these on the draw on Sunday. And the reason I say one and not two is because I already have a journal going out with one of the draws. So that doesn't make sense either, because why wouldn't I do it for both? The interesting thing is, what's hard is if you're a non-subscriber and I don't actually know who you are, then I have to give preference, of course, to who picks the journal from the number one winner. But and then I can go ahead and customize them to who you are and what you like and what your name is. And, you know, like, for example, on mine, I put everything Marmy, and I Velcroed this figurine here. Somebody had said I should laminate these figurines. I've got another Velcro piece here, and I've stuffed the pockets with surprises. And I'll probably stuff the pockets with little surprises as well. But those are the two that I've ended up making in the course of about an hour and a half. So I do them mainly because after I work for a while, it helps to take my mind off my work and transition me into my home life, which now I'm left with a great big huge old mess. But that's okay, because I enjoy doing them. And isn't that the reason why we all craft, right? Is that we enjoy doing them. So I'm going to, this is Friday night now, so I'm going to post this video tomorrow after hopefully I can edit all the bumps and crevices out of it. And on Sunday when the draw goes, this will be a part of it. So don't be surprised if you don't watch this video if I ask you how would you like your journal customized. So yeah, pink and yellow. Those are the two that I've done. And mine, of course, is the green. So, like I said, at least one will go out. At least one. I make no promises on the second package, but at least one will go out, because I don't know if that'll even fit in the envelope. I haven't even tried. So, that's my disclaimer. At least one will go out, and that'll go out to the first subscriber, comments, visible subscriber, answers all the questions, followed everything in the videos, you know, because that's the fair bit about it. But I hope to do too. We'll see. Okay, so thank you for watching this episode. Sorry about the jagged jumping around of angle shots and you know, excuse the various mistakes that I've made. But then again, you know, life is mistakes. And somebody did ask me, you know, they would benefit from watching me do it. So I did. And there's something about turning on a camera that suddenly there's pressure. You know, you feel like you're a little bit more under pressure. Whereas if I don't have the camera running, I don't tend to make a lot of these mistakes. But that's okay. Like I said, mistakes is, it helps us to get better all along. And so with that being said, remember, you're perfectly imperfect, as am I, and you're loved, wanted, and needed. And I will see you tomorrow with a draw. I love you all. Bye for now.